What is this? Open season on all white people now? We've done three or four stories in the last couple days on black people carjacking, killing, hurting, robbing all white people during a carjacking. I don't know what else to say except here's two more.
This is the team Memphis police say admitted to carjacking a man and eventually going on to kill a woman just minutes away. MPD says a short crime spree led 18-year-old Dewante Jaycox and several others into Belinda Humphreys and her husband here at the intersection of Truman and Ozan.
I was like facing down looking at my cell phone, and then suddenly someone started like knocking like very hard on the right side of my truck.
This man, who didn't want to be identified for fear of retribution, says he was robbed for his 2006 Ford F-150 by several men.
When I saw to the left side, another guy was pointing me with a handgun.
Police say the suspects tried robbing Humphreys here 30 minutes later. They were also driving a Ford F-150 when they came across five men here at the intersection. According to police, two of them tried to carjack the couple, but they fought back and they got away. Unfortunately, not before Belinda was shot.
And the next morning, we discovered that one of the bullets had come through our front door. The Lord watched over us and took care of us and kept us from harm.
Tuesday, 8 days after the killing, police finally spotted the Ford F-150 in Raleigh. Jaycox and four others were taken into custody. Both victims that I spoke with say they're grateful to be alive.
I'm not scared. We're not scared because we trust in God. If they would do something to us, I mean, it's up to God, not up to me.
He had a gun. I think it was wrapped in a shirt or something out here. And he showed it to me. He said, you don't want to die today. I said, no, I don't.
Terrifying moments for this Athens grandmother.
I just hope they find him. He needs what's coming to him.
The 73-year-old woman attacked and carjacked at this car wash on Lexington Road Wednesday afternoon.
I'm just thankful to be alive, because he could have shot me.
Still shaken, her face and hand badly bruised days after the attack, the elderly victim asked us not to show her face as she recounted the frightening ordeal.
He come up to my car and wanted to know if I had a change for a dollar.
The suspect, a black man in his 30s, approached the woman as she vacuumed her car.
But I reached over, was going to get my pocketbook, and in the meantime, he come around me and get in my car. And I guess I was fighting or something, you know, try to get him out. But he said he hit me on the head twice.
The suspect threatened her, showing the woman his gun, struck her again, then took off in her car, a blue Hyundai Santa Fe.
After he left, I was bleeding, you know, from my head. I had a sweat on, and I just grabbed it and put it up my head. And I went to down this guy. He was washing his car. And he called the police.
Then he all of a sudden just hits her.
For no reason.
No reason at all.
A granddaughter of the victim showed me how she found her beaten and nearly incoherent when she arrived at the car wash following the attack.
I mean, if the lady gave you her car, just take it, leave.
Why do you have to attack her?
That's what I'm saying.
The stolen car looks like this, a blue 2008 Hyundai Santa Fe.
One thing they don't put in these videos, if it's Memphis or Athens or 100 other chocolate cities around the country, one thing they don't put in is that people are surprised. This never happens in Memphis. This never happens in Athens, Georgia. They never say that because it always happens there. There's always some kind of black and white argy-bargy happening, and people just shrug their shoulders and go, well, you know. It's Memphis. It's the big city. We got to learn to live with it.
Please, sir. I want some more.
Yet a car pulls up at a stoplight, and a white couple gives a Muslim couple a dirty look, and that gets turned into a hate crime, all and publicized all over the country. Yeah, that's how we're rolling now. Open season on all white people. You don't even need a license. Getting a license to attack all white people, well, that would make the black kids angry.